today we are going to make crepe Suzette, but a vegetarian version of the crepe Suzette. That means the pancake itself will be eggless. And when we say crepe Suzette, the flavor that comes to your mind has to be orange. We have already spoken about the history a couple of times, but just for a recap, this crepe Suzette was made by a very young apprentice known as Henry Charpentier when his head chef was suddenly called away. So let's look at the ingredients for the product.
The ingredients to make the pancake for the crepe Suzette are refined flour, cornstarch, milk, water, powdered sugar, and salt. So to make the pancake batter, very simple, just mix all the ingredients together. So this is your refined flour that is going in, cornstarch, powdered sugar which has to be sieved. All ingredients have to be sieved, but be careful with powdered sugar because it forms lumps very easily. Salt, just mix it and add the water and milk to it. We'll mix this together, and if we find that it's become too thick and we want to thin it down a little bit, we can put a little more water, but I think this is enough. Once a nice batter is formed, always strain your batter. Allow the batter to stand at least for 30 minutes before we start making the pancakes. So we'll allow this to stand for 30 minutes before we start making the pancakes. The ingredients to make the Suzette sauce are, we have orange juice, butter, we'll use some orange zest from this whole orange, and green sugar. So to remove the zest, this time what we're going to do is, we're going to peel the orange. And after we peel the whole orange like this, we're going to remove this white part, the pith that we call. Once this is removed, we're going to make long strands from this. This we'll put in our sauce in the end and use it as a garnish also on our crepe Suzette. So in order to make this Suzette sauce, we'll switch it on, add our sugar, allow it to brown a little bit, then we'll add the butter. So now we'll add our butter and we'll just mix it together. So the whole thing dissolves and caramelizes. The sugar has to caramelize in this. So now once this is done, we're going to add our orange juice to it. And we're going to cook it for some time and allow it to reduce nicely. And then use it to make our crepe Suzette. We're going to add a few strands of our orange zest to this and allow it to cook. Alright, so to make the pancakes, first take a non-stick pan and heat it up nicely. You can use a little bit of oil to grease the pan when you're making the pancakes, but very little. So I have made a small piece of muslin cloth over here, so I can dip and do it, or you can use a small brush as well, that is also fine. So heat up the pan nicely first. Once the pan is nicely heated up, dip your muslin cloth in oil and just spread it. Here's the pancake batter. We have added a little bit of water to it to thin it down. Thank you. as you can see, once it's cooked, it will leave the sides and will become brown in the sides first. So that means it's almost done. You do not need to flip the pancake. You need to cook it from one side. This is an eggless pancake, so the color will not come that brown. The brown color that you get in a pancake which has egg in it and also good amount of sugar in it. This does not have any egg in it. The color will not be that brown as compared to your pancake with the egg. You can see it's becoming nice and brown on the sides. And you need to flip it on a plate. So once our pancakes are made, now what we are going to do is, we are going to house them in this orange syrup that we made. You can see it's become nice and thick, the syrup, and it's become a little darker because the sugar has caramelized. Each portion will have two pancakes. So we are going to place this in this nicely. If you want, you can add some more orange juice. The orange sauce in this. Slowly fold it up. And place it over this like this. The remaining sauce, we can heat it up nicely and we will pour it over these pancakes. You can see nice strands of orange zest that we had cut. They look very pretty over the pancakes. We heat it up. You all can also flambé it with a little bit of brandy. But today we are not going to do that. So this is heated up. Is going to pour it nicely over this. That's it.